For 90 years, Bennett Water Systems has been solving problems for farm organizations on the western United States. Our automated systems will lower your cost and increase your yields and get water where it needs to be on time.
Hello, I'm Matthew Malcolm with California Fresh Fruit Magazine, reporting to you here today with Brad Higby, formerly employed by Paramount, right?
Paramount.
Wonderful. Now he's working with Tresse, and they've got some things going on with figs. Most of the time we talk about navel orangeworm, people are thinking about nuts, because that's a really big problem. It's the number one pest of the nut industry here in California. But you know, it's a problem in figs too. So could you tell us some of the problems it causes in figs and what you guys are working on to introduce mating disruption?
Sure. Yes, navel orangeworm is also one of the primary pests of figs, along with nidodulid beetles. And so we're cooperatively working with the UC farm advisor up in Parlier, Houston Wilson, and doing some trials in figs to try to control navel orangeworm using mating disruption, which has been shown to be very effective in the nut crops, and we're hoping that that will translate into fig control of navel orangeworm.
Right, so what exactly do the navel orangeworm, what exactly does it do to the figs?
Well, like any navel orangeworm host, the female is attracted to the fruit at some point, lays an egg, the egg hatches into a worm, and the worm starts eating away at the fruit, in this case the fig, and basically creating a big mess and makes it unmarketable, and so that results in yield loss, and it's just not good.
Right. So how soon do you think we'll get some results of, as far as the efficacy and some recommendations on management in figs?
Yes, good question. We have 1 year of trial now. In 2018 was our first year of trials. We're expanding the trial this year in 2019. So I would suspect that 2020 would be a reasonable target date to have this product available to fig growers.
You know, I think a lot of the farmers here in the Central Valley are diversified, and so some of them might also have almonds or pistachios and right next to those orchards. So I see a benefit not just for the figs, but on behalf of their other crops, because they move from one crop to the next, right, over the season?
Absolutely, yes. They're very mobile, the moths are, and they fly between, you know, go back and forth, and they're moving around a lot. So the larger area, you can get everybody cooperating and doing similar control practices, the better results you will have.
Great. Well, thank you, Brad. We look forward to getting the results of your trials in the future. Read more about it in California Fresh Fruit Magazine. I'm Matthew Malcolm, CaliforniaAgNet.com.